dream come true.
You know, it's amazing. A lot of people having a lot of fun.
Really an amazing experience.
This is what they were planning when they were building Rome. And here it is in the 21st century.
I had seen bits and pieces of it in ADR, but I didn't want to see too much of it because I wanted to see it with an audience and with the music and, you know, the final cut.
The premiere was pretty wild, you know. I mean, not only is it Rambo, but it's in Vegas. It's got, I mean, it just is unreal.
We had the Vegas at the, you know, the Planet Hollywood Hotel and Casino, which Sly is a, you know, partner of the, and they have a wonderful facility to, you know, they have a 1,500-seat theater.
It's one of those things that, you know, you do grow up dreaming about. I mean, it was a true big style Hollywood premiere.
Whether it's Lionsgate or Las Vegas or you know, Planet Hollywood or Sly or the combination of all of them, they put together a great bash.
We did the red carpet and then Arnold Schwarzenegger turns up, as he does.
Now there he is, the Terminator. It sounds sort of a bit naff, as they say in England, but it was great.
Comes over, congratulations on your movie.
This is very special because we're all here to celebrate the great outcome of Rambo. I mean, Sly did a great job with the writing, he did a great job with the directing, producing, and starring.
You know, if you live in LA and you go to premiere, it's like, well, you go down the red carpet and then you go home, and it's over. But, you know, you do it where you have to go someplace and stay overnight. And, you know, they put us up in these nice suites.
I got flown out there by private jet and, you know, went to the UFC the night before with Sly. All very showbiz.
Did the red carpet. The movie ran. It's 93 minutes. 3.5 months and 93 minutes. And, you know, next thing I know, I got a cocktail in my hand. And it was like, did that just happen?
Normally at premieres, you always, you know, you never really get a true reaction to what the audience really feels. But most of the audience were civilians or non-film people. That's why it was in Vegas. And the reaction to it, I mean, I've seen the film 1,000 times when I sat at the back and just watched the crowd. I thought it was amazing, fantastic.
I was sitting next to my mother watching the movie, and my mom is older and, you know, very Midwest and, you know, doesn't really like action movies. And I really thought it was going to be like one of those mortifying moments at the end where she turns to me and says, well, at least you looked good, which we all saw the movie. I actually didn't look that great in. I thought it was going to be one of those. But my mom is sitting there through the whole movie, and like when Rambo gets the machine gun, she's like, yes, yes, you go, go get him.
You just didn't really go into expecting that kind of a reaction. It was positive. They were very supportive, and they were very excited to see the movie.
After the premiere, I went with Matt Marsden and my stunt double, Brian Orley, to see a public showing of it at the Arclight on the first opening weekend Sunday.
You'll get a real proper indication of what people feel about this movie, because critics can write what they want. They're there to criticize. It's the people that go and watch the films that matter.
I couldn't believe the reaction.
When Rambo came up, the entire theater just went up, and I'm like, yes.
People were cheering, people were standing up.
And it was just great to see that all the way through.
There was actually a standing ovation at the end of the movie. You know, when, I mean, even my stunt double, who was there, was shouting out, yeah, that's what I'm talking about! Yeah, fuck you! It was just extraordinary. He's very excitable.
Again, what I love about making this movie, and what I think the fans loved about it, and what we knew the fans would love about it, is we're back to the torture. We're back to this very dark character who hates who he is inside.
I knew that, you know, Rambo fans, they're going to love what comes out of a Rambo movie. Now, the level of enthusiasm is what really surprised me.
What was also really interesting to me was the new audience that we gained, which I think really was like 13-year-old boys through, you know, the 35-year-old males who just want to see brutality. And as a matter of fact, I heard it said that on our opening weekend, I think we about tied with Meet the Spartans, which came out the same day. I heard estimates that we lost about $2.5 million in box office due to underage kids who bought tickets to go see Meet the Spartans, which I think was PG-13, and then snuck in to see Rambo.
(laughs) And then what was astounding was the reaction I got from people that I knew that were in the military. One of which in particular was my son's doctor, a pediatrician. His son is in the army. They left me a long message saying that, in his opinion, he's a 50 caliber machine gunner. And he said that's exactly what happens when you shoot someone with a 50 cal. Exactly.
Hi, Marston family. David and I wanted to let you know that we went and we saw the Rambo movie, and you're right, it was bloody. It was very good, however. And we spoke to our son right afterwards, and he said, I wanted to tell you this, Matthew, that it's the most accurate and best war movie he has ever seen.
Those kinds of reactions were really surprising to me, made me very, very happy.
Another story that happened to me was there's a guy, a friend of a friend of mine, who is in the National Guard, and he got sent out to Iraq, and he just got back safe, thank God. And massive fan of Rambo, and so what I did was I got one of the big posters with Sly holding the knife down there, and I just said, to the real Rambos, thank you for keeping us safe. Schoolboy. I know that people kind of... Like, Sly's the big hitter, Sly's the star, Sly's the one that everyone wants to sign the posters of. So you kind of feel like, oh, you know, who am I just to be signing this, you know. But you don't realise what an impact it has on these guys risking their life on a daily basis, that the smallest thing brightens up their day. Just the smallest thing against some cocky actor like me signing a poster is going to make people happy and make them feel, you know, give them a bit of a morale boost when they're out there risking their lives, to me is quite humbling. So anyway, I sent it over to him. He has it on his wall in the barracks in Iraq, and he touches it, him and his boys touch it every time they go out on a patrol. And let's hope it brings them all the luck.
There are many celebrities that have been following different atrocities around the world, genocidal situations around the world, but Burma seems to have always been left on the back burner. So I thought this, we could serve two purposes, make a film that hopefully is entertaining, but also bring a light on the situation and maybe start a momentum going. So what's happened, though, is just that.
I've been reading these extraordinary reports, kind of an underground movement, you know, watching the DVDs, you know, threatened with life imprisonment, 10 years imprisonment, that kind of thing.
In present-day Myanmar or Burma, if you are caught with a pirated version or viewing this film in any way, it's 10 years in prison. If you're caught selling this video or DVD, it's life in prison. I mean, this is it's a banned object, and I think we're probably all banned from going to Burma, too.
This is the most sequestered, cut-off, cloistered, oppressive regime in the world. They've managed to shut down everything, but still, people hold out hope.
It just affected me on a very deep level. I now do work for the U.S. Campaign for Burma because of my exposure to the situation through the movie. No, I just can't seem to continue my life without trying to do something about the situation over there. I mean, I can't save the world, but I can bring awareness to it. So.
Maybe through a film being shot in the Western world will actually help their cause. And believe it or not, it is. It's actually become a flashpoint, a rallying point, and I couldn't hope for more.